They were supposed to be on the beach right now, but instead, an Adams County couple is at home this New Year's Eve, all because of a simple mistake that any one of us could make. 8 on Your Side's Matt Belanger has their story.
Jerry Combs Jr. was not supposed to be shoveling snow on New Year's Eve. He was supposed to be on a carnival cruise in the Bahamas with his fiance.
I just couldn't believe it. I mean, that was just total shock.
The couple packed their bags, traveled to the port of Baltimore, and was ready to spend 7 days aboard the Carnival Pride.
Went through security, the whole nine yards, get up to check in, and then that's when they told us we couldn't go.
Updated travel restrictions that took place June 1st of 2009 require travelers whose cruises depart from and return to the same U.S. port to have either a passport or proof of citizenship, like a birth certificate, along with a government-issued photo ID.
She said that this isn't considered a birth certificate, and like I told her, it's the only thing we've ever had.
We were both getting quite upset at that point.
Both Jerry and Linda were holding birth registration notices from the state of Pennsylvania. The documents look official, but are not considered to be birth certificates. The notices were sent out to people so they could make sure the information being recorded by the state was correct. Individuals who wanted certified copies of their birth certificate had to request one from the Department of Health. After 1978, birth certificates were automatically issued.
I was like extremely frustrated by the time we got out of there. Couldn't believe that it was leaving and we weren't on it.
The cruise line's policy states passengers without proper documentation will be denied boarding without a refund. For Jerry and Linda, it's a $2,800 mistake they hope others can learn from.
I would not want anybody else to have to go through the kind of torment, just the emotional swing of it all.
I just want everybody to be aware of you can't travel on these things, even though you've done everything your whole life with them, but it's not good enough to do any traveling or anything like that with it.
In Adams County, Matt Belanger on Your Side, News 8.
We should add the couple did not purchase travel insurance, and at first they wished they would have, but a closer look at the fine print here will show you that having the wrong travel documents would not have been covered anyway with the travel insurance. If you have a registration of birth notice, you can get an official birth certificate by calling the State Department of Health.